My name is Brianna Parker, and I'm an electromagnetic piston engine. And a piston engine is one or more pistons moving forwards and backwards inside one or more cylinders. And I split the board into two sections, a low voltage side and a high voltage side, which is this side is high voltage and this side is low voltage. And my first power source is a 120 volt plug, and it plugs right here into a slot I made in the side of the board. And it goes through these resistors, which are set up in series and parallels. And when they're set up in series, you add the values up. And when they're set up in parallels, you take the reciprocal of that number and then add it. And these resistors, which resist current for the diode bridge, and what a diode is it turns alternating current, which is current that comes from a plug in your home, and it turns it into direct current. And alternating current is the current is current that alternates from positive to negative volts. And I needed direct current to charge this capacitor, which is an energy storage device. And it's not a, like a battery, because it can charge much faster and emit its current much faster, emit its charge much faster. And so that's why this diode bridge, which is four diodes inside this little box that convert alternating current to direct current, is connected to this capacitor. And this drawing right here is of an optical switch, and it contains an LED and a transistor. And the LED stands for light emitting diode. And current can only travel one way through a diode, and this is a light emitting diode. So it emits light and it acts as base current for this transistor. Which way a transistor is, it can act as a switch or an amplifier for current. And in this case, it's an optical switch, so when this is on, the beam of light coming from the LED turns this switch on because it powers the transistor. But when I have a magnetic rod blocking that, see my optical switch is down here below the coil, when I have a rod blocking that, it's not on because the transistor cannot have any base current coming from the LED. So when it's not on, the current can't go on this side anymore. So it travels through two resistors into a transistor, which in this case acts as another switch on my board. And the transistor turns the SCR on. And that SCR is a silicone controlled rectifier. And it can, in this case, it's a switch, but it has many different uses. So the transistor turns the switch on, and then the low voltage side is off because it's being blocked by a magnetic rod, and then the high voltage side turns on from the SCR or the switch. And then the switch lets all the capacitors charge flow into the coil. When current flows through a coil, it creates an electromagnetic field. And electromagnetic field is when current propels. It can has the ability to propel only a magnetic object. So I couldn't put like a piece of popcorn in there because it wouldn't do anything, because it's not a magnetic object, because it's an electromagnetic field. So when the capacitors, energy storage devices, charge goes through the coil, then it creates an electromagnetic field, and then since my magnetic rod is blocking the optical switch, it propels it back up, so the optical switch turns back on, the low voltage side also turns back on. Gravity pulls the magnetic rod back down, and it turns the high voltage side back on, and it keeps on going up and down and up and down. And this is powered by electricity. And traditional piston engines are powered by, or in our cars, trains, boats, and they're powered by gas. And that lets off CO2 or carbon monoxide, and it goes in the atmosphere, but it doesn't affect the ozone layer. It just gets trapped inside our Earth, causing the greenhouse effect, which is a major cause of global warming, because only Americans use 375 million gallons of gas in one day, which is 136,875,000,000 gallons of gas in a year. So I would be saving a lot of gas and CO2 from entering the atmosphere by using an electromagnetic piston engine.